ahead and get into it. Because when we plan to travel internationally, there are a lot of things that we need to take into account for our budget. But one thing that we do not want to spend too much money on is making those phone calls back to the States. And that's what this episode is about. This episode is all about how to save you from going deep in your bag while you're making those necessary connections back at home. I know you may have families at home, you may got boo things at home, you may have children at home, or you might just want to, you know, do it for the gram a few times, but you're not trying to come out your bag too much. So let's get into how we can save you some money, because remember, that's what the T is. All right, so just as I did in the previous episodes, I have no problem admitting when I have a bias. So, of course, I'm going to be biased to the phone carrier that I hold, just because I know more information about it. Well, granted, I've done my research, but it ain't nothing like truly, you know, experiencing something opposed to just, you know, researching it. Now, I'm going to cover the top four phone carriers and their international packages, as well as tell you about four apps that will bless your life, baby, while you're traveling internationally and you're trying to efficiently make that call back home without going too deep into your bag. All right, so I got you, boo. All right, so let's start off with good old AT&T. AT&T has the International Day Pass. And essentially what that means is they're going to charge you $10 per day to communicate internationally. I mean, if you got it like that and you want to spend $10 a day, go for it. Me, she, her. I'm not doing that. Verizon has something very much so similar. They have what's called a travel pass. Now, Verizon said, you know what? We're going to be chill with you. All right. So this is the deal that Verizon makes. If you don't go too far, we only going to charge you that $5. It's going to be the $5 holla, okay? So, you go to Mexico, you go to Canada, it's only going to be $5. You go anywhere further than that, you for real international traveling. And they like, so $10, homie. All right. Now, when you get to Sprint, like, you know what? Okay, we got this global roaming package. 20 cents a minute. That's what you're going to pay. And you like, okay, that's kind of steep. Now we come to the carrier that, as I said, I will admit my bias, that I'm biased towards. T-Mobile is who I travel with, all right? Now, with T-Mobile, as long as you have a OnePlus plan, so they have a plethora of OnePlus plans, at that point in time, when you step foot into another country, doesn't matter how near or far, they're going to say welcome, and then they're going to say, hey, check you out, you dope, you got unlimited text messages, you got this much data, and yeah, if you happen to make a call, it's 25 cents a minute. All right, so that's 25 cents a minute. Ain't nobody paying that. All right, but what is great about that T-Mobile plan is that data and those unlimited text messages. Now, I will tell you, I am a person that I'm checking my email even when I'm out the country. I know, it's bad. Yes, I still am. If there's a lull in the day or we're moving along someplace and it just seems like it's dirt roads or whatever the case may be, I will get on social media. Perfect example, I took the train from London to Paris. Well, granted, the countryside of Paris is so beautiful. But after a while, come on, let's be real, it kind of looks like you're driving from Chicago to Wisconsin, and boo, I was over it after a little while. So I'm on social media. I'm still, you know, doing the things that I generally would do even in the States. So with that being said, I have never experienced where I went over the data that was allotted to me per day while I was internationally traveling. Now, I say that because I'm leading up to the point of this. The four apps that I'm getting ready to give you, I know we always think that, oh, you absolutely need Wi-Fi for something. No, you do not. The apps that I'm getting ready to tell you, not all of them will require Wi-Fi even when you are traveling internationally. That's good, right? So, the very first app that I'm going to talk about is an app that I use everywhere I go. It has been an extreme blessing in my life, and I pray that it's gonna be a blessing in yours. WhatsApp. Now, from what I understand, WhatsApp is owned by Facebook. But through this app, you can send text messages, you can still send pictures, you can do voice calls as well as video calls. Like, when I tell you that, for a perfect example, I'm going to use Paris again. While I was in Paris, the first time I visited the Eiffel Tower, I was able to share that experience with my family as well as my students via video call, and they told me that the reception was perfectly clear. They were able to see. I went during the nighttime, so I was a little concerned about that, but you know, the Eiffel Tower lights up, so they got to see the whole little light show. It was cute. It was amazing, okay? While I was in the Dominican Republic, we know that, you know, sometimes you travel with your boo, sometimes you don't. But when you don't travel with your boo wants to know everything you're doing. Boo wants to check in on you. Boo wants to be like, what you wearing, da-da-da, all of that. Y'all know how I go. So that's what I did while I was in the DR. Like, we were able to constantly be in communication. And just FYI, if you are a member of the Creep Squad, you can also see it will show you that it has been delivered. It will show you that it's been seen. It will show you if the person is typing. So yeah, shout out to anybody that's a member of the Creep Squad. I just helped you out. I just blessed your creepiness. All right. So yeah, I am like, and also something else that is a blessing that is in WhatsApp. Of course, this is in your settings, but you can set it up where every picture that you receive, every video that you receive, or vice versa that you send, that it will automatically save it to a WhatsApp folder in your phone. So then that way, when I was in the DR and made that vlog, some of those videos was actually from the WhatsApp between me sending things back home to family members as well as that checking up on me boo. So, I mean, like, it's great to help with memories as well. That's all I'm saying. All right. So, another app that you can utilize, and, oh, actually, before I move on, with WhatsApp, depending on who you fly with, once again, I'm going to use my bias, Southwest Airlines, you can message while you are in the sky high, traveling to your destination. You can message for free. So, you don't have to spend that $8 for internet. You're welcome. All right. So I do believe there's a few other airlines that have that same setup going on with WhatsApp. So once again, that first app that I'm telling you about is WhatsApp. All right. So it's kind of like what's up, but WhatsApp. All right. So moving right on along. I know we've heard about it for forever, but it's still going on and it's still out there helping you do what you need to do. Skype. Skype is still very much so an option that you can utilize. Now, I'm going to go through these last three fairly quickly because most people know what they are. They've used them before. So, Skype, Facebook Messenger, and Snapchat. All right, let's use social media for its actual purpose when it originated, and that was to keep us connected to our loved ones, not necessarily just to stunt and, you know, do it for the gram, stuff like that. All right. So, with Facebook Messenger, please believe you can do the voice calls, you can do video calls, as well as you can send messages. Now, in my experience, depending on how far away you go, so while I was in Dubai, Facebook Messenger wasn't the great way to communicate. The phone calls were pretty choppy, and the video calls never went through. Snapchat, I was still able to do the chat feature, but the video feature for a call, not so much. The voice for a call, not so much. But once again, I was all the way in Dubai, so that might have made a difference. Even while I was in the DR, Snapchat was a little choppy. I was able to post, but in terms of trying to actually, you know, make a phone call, that not so much. So that's why, like I said, WhatsApp is that business. All right. So I hope that I have said something that has helped you, that has made you think like, this is how I'm going to save X number of dollars, and I'm going to put that towards my next trip, or I'm going to put that towards some more adventures. So if you've heard anything that you liked, anything that blessed your life, if you know any additional things that could be a blessing to the rest of the adventurers, by all means, drop them comments below. Hit that like button on this video. And you know what? Don't be afraid, boo. Go ahead and go in that corner and go ahead and click subscribe, and then while you at it, if you want to make sure that you're one of the first that's getting served this piping hot tea that's going to save you and keep you in your bag while helping you secure the bag, by all means, go ahead and click that cute little bell so then that way you can get notifications. Well, I am Miss Liv Learn Love, and I hope that you have enjoyed this travel tea. Come on back with me for the next episode. It's going to be all about how to get your adventures internationally for the low, low. So to give you a little sneak peek, I have no problem in admitting every international trip that I have taken to date has never cost me over $2,000. And this is including airfare, hotel, transportation, shopping, food, all of that. Never spent over two stacks. So I'm going to teach you how exactly to do that in the next episode of The Travel Tea. Thank you for watching.